got you out of the relationship, don't go fucking five for his homies. Don't go fucking with the corn man. These niggas wanna know what it tastes like. What it tastes like, yo, what it tastes like, yo. They wanna know what it tastes like, yo. All this ice, it just tastes like snow. Get kimono, time to fly to Tokyo. Pitchy, pitchy, please, baby, won't you have this for me? What's up, you guys? Welcome back to the Seven Show. And I'm gonna need you guys to go with the flow. As you guys can tell by the title, today's video was that quick. 7 ways on how to successfully get over that toxic relationship. So let's just jump right into the video.
Big shout out to my girls, Kiara and Samaya, because they helped me think of steps for this video. Love you guys.
So, girl, you done got out the relationship. You've been through the arguments. He done did everything and then some to you. And now you want to successfully get out and not go back. So, the first step into successfully getting out of that toxic relationship is blocking him on everything. So, girl, you better go block him on Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, iMessage, Twitter, every single thing. Just girlies, I know how hard it is to block him on social media. Baby girl, I know. I've been through it. I know how hard it is. But girl, once you block him on social media, that relieves all the stress. It may not seem like it right now, but once you block him, that means you ain't lurking to go freaking see if he's still texting that bitch with the baby. You ain't lurking to go see some shit that you don't want to see that go make your heart drop to the motherfucking floor. Girl, you just canceling out all that shit once you block him on social media. And also, you're gaining your power back, because nigga gonna look on his phone, he gonna be like, damn, this bitch is doing for real. She done blocked me on everything. We not just block him on iMessage, we blocking him on everything. Everything so since to where you can see his existence. It's like he's not alive anymore. You don't want anything to do with him. Cancel him out our lives. Girl, we're going about our day. Fuck that. Fuck what he's doing. Next step into successfully getting over that toxic relationship is accepting it. Accepting everything. Accepted that he cheated on you 30 times and you went back. Accept that he treated you wrong. Accept that he dismissed and degraded you. Accept all of that. It's okay to accept that. You're gonna cry once you accept it. It's okay. And once you accept it, it's going to release a weight off your body. Like, yes, this happened, and I'm okay. I'm a stronger person. I'm not. That doesn't change who I am today. That does not make me any less of a person because this person did not choose to love me right. Once you accept that, I'm guarantee you that it's going to be smooth sailing from here. Once you accept that everything that he did was wrong, learn to accept everything, the good, the bad, the horrible, the everything. Just learn to accept it. Next step is getting in tune with yourself and practicing self-love. Practicing self-love is so, so freaking easy. So every day you can probably just have affirmations and different things that you say about yourself. I am beautiful. I am me. Just different great affirmations that you weren't basically feeling how you were feeling in that relationship. Because usually when girls get out of toxic relationships, they get very, very insecure. And they start to see like, what do I have or what don't I have that he can't treat me right? How can I be that perfect girl? And girl, I want to tell you right now, you're perfect. You're beautiful. You're everything. That nigga just not couldn't see your worth. Because baby, best believe, I was the best girlfriend in the motherfucking world. And I still got done dirty. You know what I'm saying? So it's not you. It's just the nigga. Niggas are deranged. You're insane. That's just get in tune with yourself, practice self-love, just love yourself. And it's a couple songs I'm gonna probably link in the description to practice self-love so you can get back to who you are. Period. Next step, spend more time with your friends. Spend more time with your friends should be very easy because all throughout your relationship, some girls, they push their friends away. And you gotta know that you wanna give a big shout out to all your freaking friends because they've been there through it all. They was there when he cheated on you for the 5th time in a row. They was there when he told you not to go with a party with them, bitch, you still went. They was there when he threw your clothes in the driveway. They was there through it all. You gotta understand, your friends are so vital in something like this. Cause when you're in a toxic relationship, more than 9 times out of 10, I would say that they will not want you hanging around with those friends. Oh, their hoes, their thighs, they just sat in the third. But your friends still stuck around. So, girl, you gotta understand that your friends has been through it with you all. So, spend more time with your friends. Love your friends. Say thank you to them for being there. Next step is get dialed up, get cute. Getting dialed up and getting cute It can go from getting your nails done to buying that cute outfit that you always wanted to buy, but you didn't buy because the nigga said that you couldn't wear it. Get dolled up, so get your hair done, get your nails done, get your eyebrows done. Just get dolled up, buy that cute shirt, get some new jewelry, like just get dolled up. Get cute, get in tune with yourself. It goes hand in hand with self-love too as well. If you look good, you're gonna feel good. If you look good, you're gonna feel good. If you look good, you're going to feel good. So get dolled up, girl. Next step is don't be so thirsty to get into another relationship. Don't look for love, let love find you. I'm gonna say it again. Do not look for love, let love find you. Do not be so thirsty to get into another relationship. So now that you're out of the relationship, don't go fucking five for his homies. Don't go fucking with the corn man. Just chill. Know it's okay to be alone. Do not be so thirsty to go back and go find a new love and putting on poke to make him mad or whatever the case may be. Girl, just chill. It's okay. Just chill. It's okay to be alone. Do not look for love. Let love find you. Because once you let love find you, it's going to be the right love. When you go searching for that, searching for the, oh, I want this, I want that, nigga, I want this. No, that's not, girl. Let love find you. You got that toxic relationship. You don't want to be back in one. So let love find you. Next step is, as Kiki was saying, boss the fuck up. Boss the fuck up can simply mean applying for those jobs you wanted to apply for, applying for that new apartment, getting that car, starting a business, doing hair, doing nails. Boss the fuck up can mean, oh, go back to school, actually doing good in school, college, just getting in tune with you as well too. So boss the fuck up can mean so many different things, and people can take it in so many different ways as long as you're making your money and you're all about you. Because before you were in that relationship, you was good, right? So now that you're out that relationship, you're going to be straight. I'm telling you this, girl, you're going to be good. Before you, let me say it again. Before you was in that relationship, you was good. Now that you're out that relationship, you're going to be good. Before you met old dude that did you bogus, his dirty little crusty little ass, you was good. And now that you out, you're going to be even better. So, boss the fuck up. Show him that that shit don't phase you. The next and final step that everybody needs to understand as to getting out of a toxic relationship is that time heals things. Girl, time heals things. I'm gonna say it again. Time heals things. So one week you could be quiet, and the next week, bitch, you could be putting on your fucking shoes to go to a motherfucking party. Girl, time heals things. Know that it takes time to get over things like that. I've been out of a toxic relationship for like a good 4 to 3 months. It's about to be like 4 months next week. It's about to be 4 months. So, as know that time heals things, because baby, it was 1 week I was crying for the whole week straight. Because I was just so sad. Like, how could you do me like this? Like, how? I done did everything and then some more. Everything and then some more, and you want to treat me bad? You know what I'm saying? So, you got to know that time heals things, and that it takes time for everything to get put together. And you got to know that everything is either a lesson or a blessing. He was either a lesson or a blessing. And after getting out of that toxic relationship, you got to realize, girl, like, okay, what did I get from this? What did I learn from this relationship? And at time, taking time is going to heal that, and it's going to make you actually realize, like, okay, this is what I got from this relationship. This is what I learned. This is what I'm never going to go through again. And with time healing thing as well, time will build up your self-worth. Time will build up your self-love. Time will build up so many different things. And you're not going to be, I guarantee you, if you follow all these steps, you got to understand, with all that being said, time is going to heal it all. You're not going to be in the same place you was last week, next year. 2 years ago, you're not even gonna know Shorty last name. As long as you don't go back to him. Because if you keep going back to him, everything is gonna repeat. The cycle is gonna repeat. He gonna be cheating on you with that bitch again. He gonna be texting that bitch with the baby. He gonna be doing everything. Everything is going to repeat. You gotta know that they not gonna change. As much as he say he gonna change, he's not gonna change. So know that time heals things and that you're going to be okay. If you follow all these steps successfully, you'll be out that relationship and be that boss beat. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want more videos like this, give this video a big thumbs up. Did you like it? If you liked it, subscribe. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one.
I told her to fly and she scared of the virus. I sent her a private to get here. I made $400 off each of these towns. I ain't tripping, it's gonna be a good year.